on to item 24. Before we open that, I would like, out of abundance of caution, I would recuse myself from any vote and discussion at this time. But I will say that I feel myself, I could be objective about this item concerning this county at this time, but I am accusing myself. So we turn the meeting over to Mr. Vice Chairman, Mr. Foff.
Mr. Chairman, before you recuse, may I, just for purposes of the record, is the basis for the recusal the familiar interest with respect to some of the property associated nearby?
Yes, sir, it is.
Just wanted to confirm that.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Before I start this next item also, Cindy, I know you're going to probably feel like I'm sort of going after you, but this is in the air and I need to ask a question or two. On property in this area, there are real estate signs of a company that you may be associated with. So my question to you is, are you, and is there any thing that you feel is a conflict in your view of this upcoming matter?
You're asking, Brian Properties holds my license. I'm an agent with Brian Properties. If I sell something, I have to pay Brian Properties. Okay. If Ricky Brian, the owner of Brian Properties, sells anything, he does not pay me, unfortunately. But that is not our arrangement. An agent, the broker, is the owner, or he is in this situation, of the company. And if he lists property, and I have no idea what all properties he has listed, but if he lists property, then he financially stands to gain in it, and I don't stand to gain anything.
Thank you for putting up with the question and answering it. I would like to say that on this item also, I believe in total good faith and with the best interest of the county. Chairman Amos called me and asked me a few days after this event happened if I would support sharing the cost. At that point, I don't think there was any determination as to who, what the cause or who the ownership was. And I agreed at that time on the phone to do this. However, since that time, the EPD has determined that there are at least two entities which are responsible one way or another for this failure and for the damage to what amounts to be county property. And so I would ask all commissioners to consider that as we discuss this. Is there any discussion about this item?
There's also additional things in the way of development, additional impact of water flow into that, that puts a burden on folks that own or may have the property like that's not within their control as well. So I think it reaches out beyond any of the owners of the property. I think it reaches out to possibly the development, the lack of hydrology studies being done correctly that puts such a burden on that dam and that lake that may not be correctly done. So it puts,
but what's before us now is authorization to pitch in for the repairs of Sanders Road.
That is correct.
That's what's in front of us right now.
That is correct. So that just adds to in a little bit, because you have to say how much does one put in and how much does one chip in, and that falls back on to whose fault it may or may not have been, and what percentage of that fault lies on who and what liability.
I mean, so how much money are we talking about right now? $15,000?
Commissioner Hansen,
yeah. Is that it?
Approximately $16,000, $17,000
from the county
would be our share.
Because the other share is 50-50.
Yes, the other share would be the City of Cumming. And with respect to Commissioner Tam's point, and no, actually, and Commissioner Levant's point, this resolution would authorize the county manager to appropriate that amount. It's 50-50 up to $50,000. But since this was drafted, we've had the invoices come in. It looks like, as Mr. Merritt said, it's about $16,000. And also, this resolution specifically says, and if you don't mind, I will read it for you just real quick, since you're not taking my word for it. That in so authorizing the expenditure of these funds, Forsyth County reserves the right to seek future contribution for the roadway damage caused by the breach dam and secure reimbursement from those individuals or entities that may be responsible. So it was drafted with the specific notion that if in fact in the future the county has an interest in seeking reimbursement for whatever may or may have not caused the damage, we would at least reserve the right to do that.
I'm okay with all this to an extent. Has this been assessed by an engineer that the repairs we're doing are just not surface repairs and there's no undermining in the soil that's just going to collapse later?
Well, this was for immediate or emergency repair. There are
somebody supposed to get the road open.
I understand, but now it's closed again. And what are we really resolving here?
Right.
And was it done correctly? Was it engineered correctly? Was there another event of rain that created additional issues? Do we keep doing this every week? Do we have rain events? I mean, at what point do we come up with a solution that works correctly and knock it out and not keep coming back here?
Commissioner Levant, I don't know the answer to your question. Your question was, first of all, and I don't believe this is a permanent repair to Sanders Road. I do know this. I do know that Sanders Road is a county road, except for that 50-foot swath of Sanders Road, which is bounded on both sides by an annexation from the City of Cumming. Therefore, the rule is if you annex on both sides of a right-of-way, you own the right-of-way upon which you just annexed. So there is city responsibility and there's county responsibility, at least with respect to the operation of the road. With respect to the fault, the ultimate fault of the damage, we are reserving. We're reserving the right to seek that. Your question also was, do we know if the whatever is being done out there with respect to this interim repair is a long-term solution? I don't think by its very nature of being an interim repair, it is a long-term solution. In fact, I would suspect that it's not a long-term permanent solution. I suspect there's going to be more work done out there, and by no means would I bring to you a resolution that commits us to some sort of an unknowable obligation financially, which is why
we've bitten the bullet. We've chosen to go out there, try to do an emergency repair. It obviously was not adequate. It had another failure again. And but we've already bit that bullet. We've committed it, so we should pay our share, fair share. But I don't want to continue doing something that's not going to be the final solution.
And I don't want to take away anything from what you said. I just want to be very candid from my perspective. I don't know why the road is closed again. I don't know that it's because the interim repair failed. I don't know if they're continuing to do more of a permanent repair. I don't know either way. I'm saying I just don't know.
But Ken, you are saying that there is a responsibility on our part as far as getting that road open and
every information I have suggests to me that to some degree the damage to the roadway extends beyond the 50-foot border that may be purely the City of Cumming's property.
Okay, and that's fine, but to me it's like if somebody throws a baseball and knocks a window out of your house, it's not your fault your window got knocked out, and if you could find whoever it is through the baseball and knock the window out of their house, out of your house, they ought to pay for the repair of the window. And if there were two houses that had windows knocked out, my house and my neighbor's house, to the degree that his window got knocked out, he ought to seek repair of his window from whoever did that as well. To me, that's the analogy we have here. The county didn't have anything to do with any of this. It was our road, either side of it or 116th or whatever. Our road was damaged through the legal action defined by the EPD as somebody other than the county. That wasn't known at the time that I discussed this, so the question is, why should the county contribute to having its property damaged when it didn't do anything, and now there are people who the EPD has declared are responsible for the damage to the road?
All right, question. Looking back in historically, when we've had other acts that have occurred that have damaged roadways, I mean, if it were to be a, I don't know, rain, or if it were to be, like I think I remember at Hickory Ridge, wasn't there a dam that was broken and it stayed broken and the road was closed, and then finally I think the county eventually had to take responsibility. I mean, I'm just saying, historically speaking, have we had to step in and pay for a road that would have been deemed not our fault?
Well, there's two.
We didn't do anything to.
Well, of course, but then do you have the legal right to go collect from the person that did the damage? You have the responsibility as a government to get the road back open for the well-being of the public, but then you also have the choice then to go after the person that caused the damage to your property.
I mean, ultimately, this is the board's call, but I mean, I can liken this to a situation of automobile subrogation. Somebody runs into you in your vehicle and damages your car. It's very likely your insurance may pay to repair your own vehicle, right? you didn't cause the accident, but your insurance will pay it. But then they will subrogate against the responsible party and then seek to recover against that party. I'm not saying that's perfect, but that may be what we do here. I mean, ultimately, this was a timing issue. The point was to go out and do something quickly. If it is in fact the pleasure of the board to seek contribution or take legal action against the responsible party, we can do that. Just know our money's not going to come in fairly, very quick.
Well, okay.
This resolution reserves the right for us to collect money for damages.
I know that.
But all we did.
Why expend them?
Because we agreed.
We agreed at first.
To partner up and open the road.
And then go back later.
For the public good.
But now it's not open.
Okay, but it was. We got the road open, and it wasn't because of the act of this that it's closed again. It's a separate situation.
Well, and that takes me to my next part. I'm not sure it is, because here's the problem we're in now.
Then you reserve the right to go back and collect the money.
We're not waiving our right.
Right. Here's the problem now, though. Nobody knows at all what the temporary fix was.
That's right. And until we do,
we also don't know how long the temporary fix will continue. We also don't know when the permanent fix will begin.
Right.
We don't know how long the permanent fix will take to occur. All these things are being blended together into one cloudy event with ongoing, are we done yet? I don't know. Are you doing this? I'm not sure. It's closed. It's open. Is it permanent? Did an engineer look at it? If it fails after an engineer looks at it, we have no ground to stand on and say, we're done. We've paid this. We're done. We want the road open. We want it fixed permanently. We're just going on and on and on, rolling down a hill where there's no resolution that comes out of this that's clear whatsoever.
But that's not what's in front of us now.
But there is one more fact I do believe has a factor in this. Can you give us the numbers? You have 50 feet of city owns the road, both sides, both right-of-ways, it's theirs.
Yes.
That part is damaged, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Outside of that 50 feet, how many feet past that is also damaged?
Who knows?
Well, that's what we should know to make a proper decision here on percentages, because if it's only a couple of feet out, if it's
that assumes a linear cost for fixing each piece of the road.
That's typically how roads are costed, by linear feet, though.
Well, there's only one area where there's that goes underneath the road.
If they have 50 feet and we have 50 feet, that's 50-50. If they have 50 feet and we only have 10 feet of ours, then it's not the same. Then maybe we should only be paying 20% or 18%. That's what I'm getting
at. I'm saying we didn't damage our road. Somebody else did.
This is just to fix it for now. We still can go back and get that.
And what I'm saying is, when will we know it's fixed?
Who's fixing the road? Who's actually taking it on, overseeing it?
It's a city project.
It's a city project.
Yes, sir.
So we have to rely on that. What the costs are and whether it's done right or not.
The temporary fix is before you. I mean, it was fully a city project, completely.
Okay,
So this now will be considered
correctly or incorrectly.
100% of the value of the temporary fix. Does everybody agree with that?
I'm sorry, say that again.
Whatever's on this page, if we pay it, pays for 100% of the temporary fix. Does everybody agree to that?
Our share.
Of 100% of the temporary
at
fix.
At that time, yes.
The temporary fix
To open the road.
To open the road. Anything that occurs, whether it turns out to be permanent or temporary from here forward, is another kind of a fix. Does everybody agree with that?
Yep, I do.
As opposed to
a temporary fix?
Yeah. The temporary fix payment
gets worse.
Is codified in 100% here in this document. Anything else that happens after this is some other kind of fix.
More permanent or temporary again. If we do this and we agree to a 50-50 split on this temporary fix, does that set precedence for the future on a more permanent fix that we should be paying half?
Not when we reserve the right to go back.
I don't know.
And Council? We don't know. Maybe the company that the mayor hired, I think I read in the paper it was Lamar Sutta, maybe he is making good on that. I mean, maybe.
It might be.
I mean, I have no idea.
Exactly. Since there's so many things here, we don't know, and no ideas of what the length is, and who owes it. why don't we reset this for 2 weeks till we get better answers?
What's going to cause a better answer? There's no reason to believe a better answer is forthcoming.
Well, we'll find out when the road reopens and why it reopened and why it reclosed. We don't have that answer.
It was open. It was a temporary fix.
Why did it close? If you do a temporary fix to open the road, why did it close again? Was it not any good? Did it not last? Did it re-rain? Did it wash it out again? We had a heavy rain when it closed. I think there's more issues before you vote on this decision.
Why don't we do what we agreed to do and reserve the right that in so authorizing the expenditure of these funds?
We all agreed to do this thinking this was going to fix the road.
No, we didn't. It's a temporary fix. It was never thought of that it was the complete and total fix. It's a temporary fix. The road's closed. Let's open the road.
Mr. Tam, why was 19 postponed?
I don't know why.
I'm asking. Was it postponed to see how we were going to deal with this item first? Just ask.
I have no idea. Let's sit on the committee. You tell me.
Let me make a recommendation. I see what you're struggling with. How about this? What if the resolution was modified? Forget about the 50% or $50,000 cap. What if it was to say, we understand that 50% of the price for the interim fix is $16,000, and that's what we pay, period. In addition, simply because we are paying 50% with respect to this interim measure in no way means we will be responsible for that percentage of any future repairs. Also keep our.
I think it says that.
Well, it doesn't say that. And I think that's what Commissioner Levant was raising. If we pay 50% here, will that be used against us in the future to say, and therefore you are on the hook for 50% of anything else? And so to the extent that that was some additional language you may want to add, that I could add that as well.
I personally like that. Okay. However, the next part is supposing that therefore shuts the door on the temporary fix.
Yes, sir.
3 years from now, if the road's not fixed, what do we do? If the road remains shut for some inordinate amount of time, I'm being dramatic here.
Right.
I don't believe it's going to be 3 years. But what if? What do we do in the meantime? Just tell people, sorry, you can't use Sanders Road?
No, well,
we're going to have an obligation. I mean, at the end of the day, other than a 50-foot swath, that is a county road. We're going to have an obligation to keep the road open, and then you'll have an obligation as the policymakers of the county to determine if you want to go after the responsible party. That's it. That's the answer. But it's a county road and we need to keep it open. But we also have obligations to be good stewards of the public purse. I understand that.
I guess we're getting it with Jim's comments are, why pay the money now before we see the whole thing's done and just settle it all out at once? It's so much simpler. Because what if you're paying this money now and then turns out that the majority was theirs and then the big fix is so much more and they... The split starts to change. I don't know. I just say you just do it all at once.
But I think Ken's motion protects that, what he just said. And we did agree
it does.
To pay it.
It does, but would it? Yeah.
I mean, it's reneging on what we...
You don't get to use that.
Well, Mr. Dare, the county manager, has the authority to issue these sorts of expenditures. But he and I both believe the better course of action, particularly given this sort of matter, was to take it to the full board of commissioners and let you
it has bigger
implications than just a little patch of.
I would vote in favor as long as you put the additional verbiage in there that this doesn't hold us bound to a 50-50 split on the permanent fix.
You want to write it up during our break, Council? Move on to the next item?
I'd be happy to. I could draft it while y'all on your next item.
Please.
Is it possible I could weigh in on that? I probably know more about this than anybody in the room.
Mr. Vice Chairman, this is a work session. Public comment. That's true.
Well, I mean, if I'm called on.
I would make a motion that the board goes on whether you hear from Mr. Moses or not. And that dies for lack of a second. So, no. Sorry.
Nothing personal, it's just not public.
Okay, I guess we're going to go on to the next item with a delay on this item, so Ken...
She needs to change the tape. Just take a 15-minute break.
Very good.
I watched the replay. I was like, oh my God.
I'd like to call the Board of Commissioners meeting back to order at 5:16. We have three commissioners here. Commissioner Tam and Commissioner Amos are not in the room right now, but it's been 15 minutes. And we are, as far as I can tell, still discussing the resolution regarding payment for interim repair on Sanders Road. Counselor has handed out a new resolution. And are there any questions about this resolution? Mr. Counselor, could you tell us briefly what you've changed?
Right, Mr. Vice Chairman, thank you. From your agenda packet, what has been changed is, first of all, the header doesn't use the figure $50,000 anymore. It uses this figure of $16,000. That's what the county manager has indicated that he would want authority of up to. The whereas, right before the now, therefore, at the very end, you'll see whereas the City of Cumming has advised that the total cost for the interim repair was approximately $32,000. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Forsyth County Manager is authorized to appropriate to the City of Cumming a sum not to exceed $16,000, constituting a 50% contribution toward the interim repairs. The next one's important. This was the one that was, I think, very important to the board. That the county's contribution of 50% toward the interim repairs shall in no way represent a precedent or signal a future intention by the county to be responsible for any future repairs or any percentage of responsibility toward future repairs that may be required along Sanders Road due to the dam breach referenced in this resolution. Fairly all-encompassing, indicating not only are we not agreeing to a percentage, but may not be agreeing to anything at all else. In addition, the rest of the language, let me just make sure before I say this, the rest of the language is consistent with what was in the prior resolution.
Is there any discussion about this?
I feel a lot better about this resolution.
I'll sleep better.
Is there a motion? If not,
Mr. Vice Chairman, I'll move that we set the resolution as presented to us by council. The one that speaks to our contribution being $16,000.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0. Amos recused, and I will turn the meeting back over to the chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Boff. Item 25.